Good day. My name is Marian Josic and I was chairman of obsolescence management group within Airing Industry Activity. AWC, AMC and FSAMC are Airing Industry Activities. It is an industry program to establish technical standards known globally as Airing Standards and to develop shared technical solutions that no organization could accomplish independently. I will tell you the story about obsolescence and Airing Standard 662, titled Strategies to Address Electronic Component Obsolescence in Commercial Aircraft. Let me introduce you to Octopus. Octopus is a dangerous animal, and you can attach to every of those tentacles something. In our case, in case of our MROs, every big problem of an MRO can be attached to tentacle of the octopus, because every big problem at MRO can also strangle you like octopus tentacle can strangle you in real life. Let me introduce you to tentacles of MROs. Tentacle number one is limited availability of parts and repairs. Tentacle number two is high price escalation. Tentacle number three is a reduction of content of manuals. Tentacle number four is poor delivery performance. Tentacle number five is end users agreement, non-disclosure agreement. Tentacle number six is pushing for additional business. Tentacle number seven is limited access to tooling. And of course, tentacle number eight can only be obsolescence. In the rest of the presentation, I will only talk about obsolescence. Why is aviation concerned by obsolescence? Electronic market in commercial off-the-shelf components and in avionics components and aircraft business, they have some common things. They use piece parts which cannot last as long as end product. Let me ask you a rhetorical question. My rhetorical question could be, what is the average lifetime of your smartphone? And of course, you will tell me 1 to 2 years. If we talk about the average life of your laptop, it's 3 to 4 years. If we talk about the average life of your car, some of people who are driving Rolls-Royce will say 50 years. But average car will last 10 to 15 years. But if you are talking about aircraft, the average lifetime of aircraft is 30 to 40 years, which is quite long. It can be compared to trains and to ships, because aircraft is not an isolated case. Those complicated machines, they are built to last long. Let me tell you about types and causes of obsolescence. There are different types of obsolescence. In our discussions during writing of Airing 662, we have found that there are 6 different types of obsolescence. Obsolescence of piece parts, obsolescence of chemicals, obsolescence of components in the aircraft, obsolescence of test equipment in your shops, obsolescence of software, and obsolescence of people. Of course, there are causes for those obsolescence. The causes could be regulatory mandates and legislation, new technologies, life limits of piece parts, and market-driven economy. If we talk about aircraft components, the life of a component will start with aircraft component concept. Then it goes to component design, component production, and there is that magic date that they announce, it is end of production of the component. That doesn't necessarily mean that is end of life of component, because when you say end of the production, there are still piece parts that they can deliver, suppliers, they can deliver piece parts, and also they have engineers which are still able to support your component. Next step is end of support. That means that engineers are assigned to different projects, so they are not anymore in the area, and there are no piece parts on stock to be delivered. That also means that is end of life of your component. The average component would last approximately 7 years. That means that in the lifetime of aircraft, there will be 3 or 4 cycles of those components. That is why I draw that guy Sisyphus. Sisyphus is a Greek guy who is pushing the stone uphill. Once when it is on the top of the hill, the stone will roll down and he will start all over again. And that is how it works with components. Once you reach end of life of component, you go all the way down and start with a new component which is better, more reliable and has more capabilities. Comparing a life cycle of the airplane with life cycle of component, we can say that in a life cycle of aircraft and component, there are some similarities. Similarities could be like there is a concept in both cases, development, production, operation and disposal. It is very wise to do obsolescence risk analysis now and then in the life cycle of the aircraft to figure out what is going on with your components and if there is any obsolescence around the corner. In our discussions in ERINC 662, we have designed the obsolescence decision matrix. On a horizontal line is a probability of occurrence and vertical is possible impact. So we have designed 3 colors. That is green, yellow and red. Green means low risk, yellow is moderate risk and red is high risk. I will give you example for 2 cases, low risk case. That can be a light bulb somewhere back in the cabin. Let's say reading light is failing, you cannot repair it because light bulbs for reading lights are not on the market anymore. That is not that difficult because there are many manufacturers producing light bulbs, and with just a little bit fiddling and engineering work you can get a replacement and you are fine to go. Another problem is if you run into complicated component like display in cockpit. In that case we are talking about quite a probability of occurrence because still that the display is using some commercial off-the-shelf parts, and possible impact can be very high. You can run into a situation that you cannot repair the display and then your operation will stop because you cannot fly the airplane. So in that case, that is high probability of occurrence and very high impact. Now, what can you do with that result? So you can have a risk assessment results which can be low, and then you can choose for a reactive approach. It can be like do nothing until item is obsolete and then act. Or if there is a high or medium risk, then you have to choose for proactive approach, and then that is much more work, of course, but you have to design the plan. The biggest difference between reactive and proactive approaches is that by proactive approach there is a plan. The selection of strategy should always be the result of decision process and risk analysis. And then you can do some interesting things. There is a human factor around the corner regarding obsolescence, especially with choosing of obsolescence manager. In case of reactive approach, the obsolescence manager could be a guy who is enjoying being cold during the night. He can work under pressure, take risk and solve your obsolescence fast. In case of proactive approach, you can better choose for a guy who is calm, who can see a big picture and who is able to find the structure and make a plan in advance. So let's talk about stand and fall matrix and mitigation. Case number one is drop-in replacement. Mitigation could be just implement solution and you stand. Case number two is modification is required. There is no drop-in replacement. In that case, the best next step is to do the bridge buy, to buy some time for you. And then after you have components, you can implement solution by designing a system to be able to make component working in a new situation. And you still stand. Guess there is no replacement, then the best choice is to do the last time buy or lifetime buy. And in that case, there are two possibilities. There is a stand and fall. Let me explain. Guess you are cheap and you don't want to spend much money. You buy just a few piece parts which became obsolete, and in a couple of years you figure out that you didn't buy enough piece parts and you have a very big problem and you fall. Another extreme is that you spend a lot of money, you buy hundreds of thousands of piece parts, and then you can use your component, but at the end, when you phase out your airplane, you will figure out that you have a lot of piece parts on the stock. That means that you have spent much more money than it was required. So in that case, when there is no replacement and you are dealing with last time buy, you always have to watch carefully to buy a good amount of piece parts to be able to do the operation, not to overstock your stock with too many piece parts and not to understock. So it is very, very important to keen out to make a good quantity to buy. Case number four, there is no replacement, there is no last time buy, there is no lifetime buy, there is no solution, and it's definitely fall. Well, here is obsolescence example. Obsolescence example is given on lighthouse. For 100 years, lighthouse was using 40 watt filament light bulb. 95 of energy is wasted, it's transferred into heat instead of into light. It is inefficient technology. Somebody could ask why 40 watt filament light bulb. It is because 40 watt is a more reliable light bulb type than 7500 or 150 watt. That's why. And after many years, the legislation hits. The governments, they decide that it is inefficient technology, it is too much energy wasted in heat, so they say to manufacturer of 40 watt filament light bulb, you cannot produce them anymore. So you have to do the mitigation of obsolescence. How you do that? Step number one would be bridge buy, meaning buy a lot of 40 volt light bulbs. You know the reliability of light bulb and how many months can they work, and you can easily calculate how many light bulb you will need for next 10, 15, 20 years. And you can decide to buy hundreds of those light bulbs and continue your operation. But you can also decide to do step two, which is technology insertion. You can do step one, buy limited amount of light bulbs and buy some time to hire engineers who can redesign the system in such a way that you can use LED diodes to produce light, which is better technology and it is not so much energy wasted. And then, once when it is done, the whole modification and design, You can easily transfer from old type of operation using 40 watt filament light bulb to new type of operation using LED diodes. Here I would like to introduce the rule of three. Let me first explain what is rule of three. Rule of three is providing three words, three important words for certain case, which can be remembered very easy. Like in traffic, there is a rule: stop, look and listen. Everybody knows about Mark Antony's speech in Shakespeare tragedy, friends, Roman countrymen. Or in Olympic Games, there is that Veni, Vidi, Vici. And French in Revolution, they had the slogan Egalite, Fraternite, Liberté. So that is very easy to remember, those words in Rule of Three. In our obsolescence world, Rule of Three would be prevent, detect, and fix. To explain how it works, the following. Aircraft life cycle. There is a design, manufacturing, and support phase. In design and manufacturing phase, our supplier, our aircraft manufacturer, airframer, is designing aircraft and manufacturing aircraft. Then, after that, he hands over aircraft to his customer, to operator, which is flying aircraft and earning money, and manufacturers supporting that aircraft. Now, in design and manufacturing phase, we have prevent phase of obsolescence. What means that? Means that manufacturer is doing impact analysis, he's choosing components, the selection of components is very important, he's choosing components which are built to last, and he's specifying parts such that those parts can be built and purchased on open market. Then he hands over aircraft to operator, and then if you look at obsolescence, there is the detect phase. The most important part is to detect obsolescence on time or before it occurs. So you need to do impact analysis, surveys. Boeing and Airbus are claiming that they do survey every 2 years. They interrogate their suppliers and asking if there is obsolescence in next 2 years. Then there are those obsolescence management plans to be made. Engineers have to follow commercial bulletins, which are coming to purchasing departments because they are commercial bulletins. So you have to make sure if you are at the engineering department to get those commercial bulletins, not technical bulletins, commercial bulletins. Sometimes purchasing department just see them and put it aside. So you have to make sure that they proceed those bulletins to engineering group. There are smart PCNs, that is electronic deliver of information about obsolescence. And you can interrogate manufacturers and ask them, do you expect any obsolescence in the near future? Okay, when you detect obsolescence, there is that fixed phase. In fixed phase, you also have to do impact analysis. You do the bridge buy, think about the lighthouse, you start with the bridge buy and then design technology. So there is a bridge buy, technology insertion, or you can choose to do nothing and fall, or do nothing and at the moment that you cannot operate your aircraft anymore, you park it in a desert or you scrap it. So to recap, obsolescence is coming if you like it or not. Will you stand or fall is your choice. Never forget tentacle 8 and obsolescence rule of 3, which is prevent, detect and fix. And obsolescence is the tiny dash between availability and unavailability. So finally, there are a few tips and tricks. First, I would like to tell you that there are three important hiring specifications. One is standard for cost-effective acquisition, which is ARIN 674, better known as KIA. Then equivalency of test equipment, ARIN spec 668. And this one, that is ARIN report 662, strategies to address electronic component obsolescence in commercial aircraft. Besides that, there are other suggestions for quick fix. New technology like 3D printing or 3D scanners, lifetime buy, open specification, reverse engineering, cloning of equipment, go to conferences to meet other people and think out loud. There is always a solution to find at the AMC conference. Subscribe for several database services, dealing with obsolescence, of course. You can also decide to make a business case and outsource the whole obsolescence issue in your company and let somebody else solve it. You can look at secondhand market for components, or you can visit regularly My Boeing Fleet or Airbus World, because they are also providing information about obsolescence, because they are interrogating their suppliers every 2 years, and very fresh information can be found on their site. So at the end, thank you very much for listening. This was a short story about ARIN 662, strategies to address electronic component obsolescence in commercial aircraft. My name is Marian Jozic, and I'm AMC Chairman Emeritus.